iRecord is a website for sharing wildlife observations. Its goal is to make it easier for wildlife sightings to be collected, checked by experts, and made available to support research and decision making. You can register for free, and once you're logged in, you can add your own biological records and images for others to see, as well as look at what other people have recorded. Experts can review your sightings, and the information can then be shared with other users and will be made available to national recording schemes and local record centres. In this guide, we will take you through the steps of registering for an account, taking part in a specific iRecord event, and uploading your wildlife sightings. First, let's look at setting up an account. Enter this link into your internet browser on your computer, tablet, or smartphone. If easier, you can copy and paste the link from the instruction guide on our website. This page will appear and you can enter your details, such as username, email, password, and name. If you are under 16 years old, you can still create an account. Just be sure to tick the Under 16 box when signing up. Tick Agree with Terms and then click Create New Account. A confirmation email will be sent to you to activate your account. Access the email and follow the link within to confirm that the details you gave were correct. You have now successfully made an iRecord account. Follow this link to take you to the login page. You can now enter your username and password to log in. Now, let's look at joining a specific event on iRecord so that you can start adding your wildlife sightings to it. Let's use Zoology Live 2020 as an example. Once you are logged in, the easiest thing to do is to follow our link to the event page. Enter this link into your internet browser to take you to Zoology Live 2020. Alternatively, you can search for the event yourself. On the homepage, look for the menu option called Activities. This will either be visible at the top of the page, or you will have to click on Main Menu to see a drop-down list and then select it. Click Browse All Activities and type in Zoology, then click the Go button. You should see that Zoology Live 2020 comes up. To the right, there is a column called Actions, which contains a button with a star on it. Click the star. This will take you to a new page where it will ask you if you want to join the event. Click the button Join. Zoology Live 2020 should now be added to your activities. Anytime you log in to iRecord, you can click the Activities tab on the homepage and view Zoology Live 2020 by selecting My Activities. Now you are a member of the Zoology Live 2020 event, let's look at uploading a wildlife recording using an internet browser. The best way to start is to take a photograph of the species you have seen. You can then upload this with your record and people can verify your sighting. On iRecord, navigate to the My Activities tab. If you have joined the event, you will see Zoology Live 2020 listed here. Under the Links column, click on the button Submit Records of any species you have seen. This will take you to the What Did You See tab. First, enter the date of the recording and the name of the recorder. Then, for each species you have seen, you can add a separate entry. In the first column, Species, you can start typing in either the English or Latin species name. A drop-down list of close matches appears, and you can choose from these options to select the right species. This can be helpful if you only know the common name. If you are not sure which species you have found, you can enter your best guess, and then in the Certainty column, change the drop-down menu to Uncertain. If you are sure about what species ID you have seen, then keep this listed as Certain. If you do not know the specific species, but do know a higher classification like butterfly or insect, you can write these more general identifiers in the species column instead. In the column Quantity, you can write how many of each species you have seen. If you know it, you can also record the sex and life stage of the species by filling in the columns Sex and Stage. For example, you may know that you have found an adult female butterfly. If you have any extra information, you can add this in the column Comments. Finally, you can click the Add Images button to browse for and upload the specimen images you have taken. If you would like to add records for more species, A new row will have appeared. Simply repeat the process until you have added all of your records. Now click the Where Was It tab. This allows you to record where you found the species. First, under location, you can write where the species was spotted. For example, you may write Coldham's Common, Cambridge. Then you need to enter a spatial reference, which will allow your records to be displayed on a map. If you already know a spatial reference for your record location, such as a British National Grid Square, then you can enter this information where it says Enter a spatial reference. Alternatively, you can search for the name of a location and choose from a list. Where it says or search for a place on the map, type in the location, click the search button, and select the correct location from the list. The third and final method is to use the map on the right of the screen to manually select the right location. Use the plus and minus symbols, highlighted here, to zoom in and out, and the arrows at the top left of the map to move around. Then, when you are happy you have found the right spot, click on that location on the map. The square area you have selected should be highlighted red. Finally, under the Habitat and Overall Comment headings, you can select the type of habitat your species was found in from a drop-down list and add any final notes. Click Submit, and your record will be added to Zoology Live 2020. If you have records from different locations, you will need to fill in multiple upload forms. Now let's try uploading a record using the iRecord phone app. You can download the iRecord app for free from the Google Play App Store on Android devices or the App Store on Apple devices. Once you have registered your account, please see earlier in the video for instructions on how to do this, you can then open the app and log in by entering your username and password. Once you have joined the Zoology Live 2020 activity, again, see earlier in the video for instructions on how to do this, you can select the Activities tab at the bottom of the screen. A list of the activities you have joined should be displayed. Click Zoology Live 2020 and a tick should appear next to it. Any recordings you make will now be added to this event. Make sure the app can access your phone's location so that your species records can be added to a map. To add a new record, click the green plus button at the bottom of the app's homepage. Start typing in the species name and it will autocomplete with options for you to select. You can type in the English or Latin names. If you do not know the specific species but do know a higher classification, like butterfly or insect, you can write these more general identifiers here instead. When you have done this, a draft record entry will then be added to your Pending tab at the top of the homepage. You can click on a draft record to add in the rest of the data. If you have allowed iRecord to use your phone's location, some information will be auto-completed. If you click on Location, you can then fill in the rest of the information. First, write the name of the record location at the top. For example, you may write Jesus Green, Cambridge. If the rest of the record location has not been filled in automatically, you can select it on the map manually. You can move around the map in different directions by swiping your finger and zoom in and out using the plus and minus buttons. When you are happy you have found the right spot, click the grid square closest to where you found your species and it should highlight red. You can click the green arrow in the top left of the screen to get back to the rest of your records data. You can then select the date the recording was made and add a comment if you have any other useful information to include. Zoology Live 2020 should already be listed under Activity. If they are known, extra details can then be added under Abundance, Stage, Sex, and Identifiers. For example, these categories could record that two specimens of a species were seen, that both were adult males, and that they were identified by John Smith. Finally, at the bottom of the screen, you can click the green camera icon to search through your phone and upload any pictures you take of the species you see. When you are happy, go back to the overview of your record and click the Upload button in the top right of the screen. Your record will now have been added to Zoology Live 2020. Once you have uploaded your wildlife sightings, you can now view them on the event page. Let's take another look at Zoology Live 2020. Log into iRecord on an internet browser. Go to My Activities. If you have joined the event, you will see Zoology Live 2020 listed here. Under the Links column, click on the button Zoology Live 2020 Summary. Click here for a map with all recordings. This will take you through to a map where you can see the locations of all the species that have been recorded as part of the event. If you have uploaded any records, these will be displayed here too. Beneath the map, there is a Records tab. This will display all the information for the species that have been uploaded, including their name, where they were seen, and who recorded them. This will allow you to find your own records and see what everyone else has found. If you click on a record in the table, it will be highlighted on the map. The tabs Species, Taxon Groups, and Families give a full list of all the species and higher classification groups, such as insects, amphibians, and mammals, that have been recorded as part of the Zoology Live 2020 event. Finally, the Photos tab will show a gallery of all the images that have been uploaded. You should now be able to sign up for an account on iRecord, join a specific event, upload wildlife recordings, and view an event summary showing all of the species that have been found. We hope you enjoy using iRecord and sharing your wildlife sightings with others.